WMC Memphis, WMFS HD2 Bartlett Memphis, ESPN 790 AM with Colin Cowherd and The Herd, weekday mornings from 9 a.m. till noon.
The views and opinions of the hosts or guests of the following program do not necessarily reflect those of the management or staff of Intercom Memphis.
Watch the sunrise, new day's dawning, and it's calling you and me. We're the mighty by Memphis, Tennessee. We've got woodlands, fields, and water. Hey, there is no better way. You can find out all about it on Outdoors with Larry Ray. Make some time, take the family, ask a friend. But don't delay. Listen up and learn about it all. Outdoors with Larry Ray. Listen up and learn about it all. Outdoors with Larry Ray.
Good Saturday morning. Welcome to another edition of the award-winning Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790. Brought to you proudly by the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency, Gaston's White River Resort, and Barton Power Sports. Now, here's your host, Larry Ray.
Hey, good Saturday morning. Welcome to Outdoors with Larry Ray. And yes, I am back. This is my radio voice, but this is my voice that I have right now, which is much better than it was last week when I had no voice. And appreciate Dave Gabbert sitting in for me, and Greg Ratliff, our show producer. I had a chance to listen to it. You guys did a great job, Greg. Thank you. Yeah, y'all kept up with a lot of stuff going on, and I could have whispered and come on, but not with fever and everything like that. So doing well, and sorry that we did not have open mic Saturday last week, but we will be back on tune in August, August the 1st, in fact, and we'll get back to that, being able to talk to you folks out there in radio land and give away these prizes that are building up in my garage.
I'll take them.
I know you will. I've already given you some. Ron Wong, this is second Saturday of the month, which means Ron is in studio. Good morning, Ron.
Good morning, Larry, and good morning, everybody out there in radio land. It's a great Saturday morning.
I'm just glad to have you.
Going on. Well, thank you very much.
It's good to see you.
I'm always just so happy to be here.
Well, you're not a frequent flyer, you're a frequent driver. This man, he's everywhere. If you know about him, did you get to do your rodeo? Did the rain get you, or did you get to do the fishing rodeo that you were?
We had some really bad weather.
Yes,
last weekend.
I thought about you.
The Walnut Grove Lake Homeowners Association has an annual fishing rodeo.
Yeah.
And they had scheduled it for Friday, July the 3rd. And, everybody knows what happens the morning of July the 3rd. It was torrential rains and a little bit of booming going on and a very nice light show coming out of the sky and everything.
Yeah.
So they decided, well, let's wait until Saturday morning and we'll do it. So they did.
They did.
And and of course, one of the things that I like to talk to everybody about when I'm doing one of those tournaments is, hey, tune into Outdoors with Larry Ray.
And you are the
all
man.
Of them were very, very appreciative. They want to thank Outdoors with Larry Ray for all the help that they provided for the rodeo. And it was great, because what was so good about it was there was an equal amount of kids and adults.
Well, good. Okay. Yeah.
And what a great way to get kids introduced into fishing. And we made sure that every kid that was there received at least one door prize.
There you go.
And I got to tell you, it was heartwarming to see that.
Well, I know we love those junior fishing rodeos, and of course, Ron, there's so many things going on right now in the Mid-South. Of course, we're over the July 4th weekend. Safe boating. We appreciate Brian Thompson coming on. I hope everybody had a great July 4th weekend. It was not any fun at my house with me being sick. Then my wife got sick, and we ended up grilling a little thing out on the patio. But had a good time. And then Ron is getting today's show. You know, we're going to talk a lot about fishing because a lot of you folks want to know what's going on locally, and we're going to hook up with Steve McAdams. Hopefully up Kentucky Lake. A lot of water on Kentucky Lake, on the Tennessee River. A lot of water on the Mississippi River.
There really is. And, you know, the Ohio River, the White River, they're all overflowing right now.
Yeah.
They've got some bad flood conditions. And, you know, you think about the Memphis area here. It's almost unheard of to hear of our the Mississippi River in our back door here being at the 30-foot stage this time of the year.
In July.
That's right.
That's just amazing.
That's,
you know, I mean,
that's almost unheard of.
Yeah, yeah, and that's all the rain. Not only
it's
not really
north.
It's a north rain. It's not our
rain here. No,
because our rain's going to go into the Wolf and go into other places.
That's right. It's coming out of the Ohio River.
Yeah.
And the upper end of the Mississippi River, they have flood conditions on the Ohio River, and of course the White River, coming out of Branson and all of that.
Yeah.
They are experiencing tremendous flood conditions, and on the Arkansas River. What happens is because the White River flows into the Arkansas River, which flows into the Mississippi River below Helena, Arkansas there.
Yep.
Well, as that backs up and you've got water coming in from the Ohio River above Memphis, it just starts backing up. And so unheard of river levels. And so, you know, anybody that gets out there, you know, please exercise a lot of caution, because as the water rises, all of the dead timber and stuff like that's on banks starts to float off, and it floats into the river, and that's a hazard. You got to be careful, and what you see sticking up is only the tip of the iceberg.
Yeah, because and I know our folks over at the White River, we had Ron Brandeman. We had the report from Ron over there. They do have their flow going.
Yes, they do.
They do have their flow going.
But the trout continue to bite.
Oh, the trout continue to bite. So we're just a few minutes into the show, and I'm in our first cough drop already. So this may turn over to be Ron Wong a little bit later as we get into this. But I wanted to talk to Ron a little bit on this first segment as we roll into today's show and talk fishing and things like that. But Ron's got a lot of things going on with him because the big event's going on in Alabama this morning.
That's right. As soon as I can get out of the radio station here.
You're heading to Alabama.
7:30 this morning.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be heading to Leesburg, Alabama, which is on Lake Weiss.
Yes.
It's the Bass Pro Shop, Big Cat Quest by Ken Freeman.
Mm-hmm.
And it is one of their, they have two or three different hourly weigh-in catfish tournaments, and this is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's quite interesting to see how these guys go out and try to catch these big catfish and determine whether or not they do or they don't weigh in hourly, because they give prizes hourly. Then, of course, they give the overall. But I'm going to be covering that, and anybody in the Leesburg, Alabama area, which is pretty close to Birmingham.
It is.
And
yeah.
Come on out, because this is a great spectacle.
It is. And then you just roll into there, and then you'll roll right out of there.
That's right. Well, and you know, I want everybody to go out to Outdoors with Larry, or
LROutdoors.com. That's it.
We're going to have some pictures of the Big Cat Quest there at Lake Weiss up on the website of first part of the week.
Well, Big Cat. I mean, when they say that, what are you talking about?
Anything, something over 20 pounds.
Okay,
these blues can be all the way up to 80 pounds.
Ooh,
I mean,
yeah.
These are huge.
These are huge fish.
These are really huge.
Yeah.
And
folks, you can go to Big Cat Quest, just Google it on there. I go to it and look at it and see the pictures of some of these big
fish.
And
we're going to have pictures on LROutdoors.com.
Yeah.
Well, and after I do that all day Saturday, I am going to rest there in Leesburg.
Good for you.
And
a day of rest for Ron.
Bright and early Sunday morning.
Yeah. Heading?
I'll repack my car and be heading to Orlando, Florida.
Orlando. He's not going to Disney World.
Well, no, I'm going to go to SeaWorld.
You're going to SeaWorld. But he's not going down there to see the sights because there's a big event going on down at
the... That's right. Larry, you've been to...
I've been to it.
Huge event. It's ICAST.
Yes.
It is the International Fishing Tackle Manufacturers Trade Show, the world's largest.
Huge.
Well, yeah, really huge. When we talk about what I'm going to get to experience is about 500,000 square feet of fishing tackle.
You need a GPS to walk around in there.
You're going to need it. I have downloaded the ICAST app onto my phone.
Good.
I can make my appointments. And I got to tell you something, folks. We're going to, here on Outdoors with Larry Ray, really talk a lot about a lot of the new products that are going to
This is when they come out.
They introduced all of the 2016 stuff.
Yeah.
And so we're going to get firsthand experience, and you're going to hear about it here on Outdoors
I'm
with
excited.
Larry Ray.
I'm excited.
And, you know, we got a lot of things coming up because, you know, not right after ICAST, we're looking at the Forest Wood Cup there in beautiful God's country, as Larry would say, and in Hot Springs. And so, you know, we're going to be covering that, but we're also, later on this month, we're going to have, can I say this?
Yeah, you can go
Scott
ahead.
Scott Martin, Angler of the Year for the FLW Tour on.
Yes.
And then along with that, I'm going to be setting up some interviews from ICAST with some of the manufacturers talking about the new tackle that's coming out.
Well, we got a great July coming up, and nail down that Scott Martin. I think his dad's somebody we know. I think it is.
Roland.
Named Roland. Yeah, that's what Bill Dan said. Roland somebody. But anyway, nail down Scott, and that'll be on the fourth Saturday of the month when Ron is in here so Ron can interpret what Scott tells me. And everything for
you
us.
You won't have a problem.
No, I won't have a problem with Scott. Let's take our first break of the morning. Going to come right back, and we're going to try to hook up with Steve McAdams up on Kentucky Lake to talk fishing on Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790. You can find